Before I get into today's video, I'd like to give a huge thoughts and condolences to any of the victims and their families that were involved in the mass shootings anywhere that they occurred, and anywhere in the events the last month. There's no place for hate in this world. No matter your skin color, ethnicity, race, sex, you're welcome on my channel, and you're
Hello,
welcome anywhere
everybody.
for that matter,
Welcome
and
to
we do
Project
not
Michael
condone
Dunn.
hate. I want to
And
say
we
a
do not
huge
condone
thank you
violence.
to
And
shout out
my
to
thoughts
all
all
the
the
people
people
who
who
watched Family
watch
Members
Members
have checked out the
and
channel
this
so
so
far.
far.
This
And
is only this is
listening
gonna be
to
my
today's
first
video.
actual video. I just want to clarify the purpose of this channel. This first video was sort of just a big montage and or teaser of what's to come. My goal is to be the biggest and or number one channel on YouTube for all things Megalodon content, whether it's trailer, books, anything, movie related, covering anything I can. Anything I want to be the number one Megalodon place on YouTube, in terms of content. And I thought it would be only appropriate today for the first video to make a minor tribute and or a big shout out and big thank you to the man that I'm dubbing the father of the Meg, Mr. Steve Alton. For those of you who don't know him, he is the author of the Meg series, and he has gotten quite the portfolio of books now. He's got the first Meg book, he's got The Trench, he has Primal Waters, Night Stalkers, Hell's Aquarium, Generations, and the upcoming Meg Purgatory. He's also on the Locke series. And if you haven't read any of his books yet, they're very easy to read. It's not like you have to have some kind of obnoxiously easy reading level or anything like that. I feel like you could probably get them down pretty nicely. But they're very easy to read. I would think even younger kids who maybe haven't mastered reading it could probably read them very easily. But I want to thank this man for what he's done to the pop culture world in terms of bringing Megalodon to a wide audience. For those who probably will never know what the Meg is like in terms of written content with his book series, Warner Brothers adapted the movie to become a major motion picture. And if you haven't seen the Meg yet, I strongly recommend it. Not just me being a shark enthusiast and being a huge fan of Megalodon, but it is just shed some light on what it would be like if that creature was around today and in our waters. And I think the huge thing to point out here is that people who never heard of him and never read his book but seen the movie, because it's a movie, it's easier to consume a movie and its storyline than it is to read a book, because a lot of people either lack patience to read it or they just simply don't have enough time to read, which is always a problem this day and age. But in terms of the movie goes, he brought that book into the storyline with the movie's adaptation, and thankfully the book deal went into a movie deal. And I just think the best part is, like I said, this movie has shown a huge millions of people audience around the world, a modern day Megalodon. Yeah, you can argue that it's not historically accurate with the size, because but H Hollywood has always been notorious for blowing stuff up. For instance, they will argue that Megalodon reached a max of like no more than 60 feet. I think that on record is like 58.7 was like the max actual like footing that scientists have figured out. And in the movie, they've bumped it up to 75 feet. And you can kind of tell how freaking massive the female is in the movie. 75 feet is enormous. That would be 15 feet bigger than the largest recorded Meg from the Miocene era. But that's not the point that I'm here to make. It is incredibly hard to get kids and or anyone who's not into sharks to get it in their head that there are things that they will never see in their lifetime, that lived millions of years ago. And the fact that one man's book brought a prehistoric monster to the big screen and exposed millions of people to this new Apex Predator on the big screen is an establishment in itself. I mean, most people say, oh, it's just a giant shark. What's the big deal? Everyone is afraid of great whites. No, everyone who says they don't want to go swimming is, oh, the sharks have freak me out. The biggest shark this day, 20 feet. Imagine a 60-foot version of a great white. Now, you know, they would argue that the Megalodon has been basically proven that it is not a cousin of the Meg, because Carcharodon is not a scientific name. Everyone says that it came from a line of big tooth, Ordidus. So Ordidus Megalodon is technically the scientific name ripped to my tattoo that's got Carcharodon on it, which it's fine. It's, you know, at the end of the day, it's a tattoo. It is what it is. But just imagine a 60-foot version of a great white. You're scared of a regular great white. But I digress. I don't want to, you know, get too off tangent here because this is about him. But I first met Steve on a Zoom call. Funny enough, I'm gonna get into a separate video on this just because this is a story of its own. But he had a contest on his webpage for one of the games involved in his website, Sea Monster Cove, and essentially, he was giving away a free Megalodon tooth to the person with the highest score. And I'm a competitive person, and I'm also a gamer, so my first thought is I had to compete for this. But anyways, fast forward, I win the contest, and I'm on the Zoom call, and, you know, I've seen this guy on, you know, interviews. I saw him in a couple of specials related to Megalodon, but just to talk with him in person was a huge... I was kind of starstruck, because I've never met... I don't want to call him a celebrity, because, you know, people... You know, not the correct terminology for that, but you know, a very wealthy author. When I first met him, I was like kind of starstruck, and then I realized I'm like, this is just a normal guy who's just doing the things that he loves, the people around him, and he's making a living off of you know, his imagination, and there's nothing better than that. And Steve, if you get to watch this video, thank you from the bottom of my heart for writing the books that you did, because not only have they brought this world into my head and now I'm obsessed with it, but I've now got a tattoo on my body. You know, I got Megalodon stuff up the wazoo. I have the sticker on the back of my truck. I have wallpapers. I have your Megalodon tooth in my collection, which is a freaking honor just to say that. From anyone who is a huge fan of the movie and the books, we don't have enough to say about you. The things that you do, the way that you write stories. I know that the movie isn't a direct adaptation of the book, because Hollywood's gonna do that, but it's still like you're still the modern father of a 60-foot, you know, technically 75-foot from the movie shark, and it is nice to have met you, and it's also nice to, you know, be able to communicate again with you every month in your Zoom calls. For anyone who doesn't know, his website, Sea Monster Cove, or his book website, SeaBelton.com, you can subscribe to his newsletter and contact his assistant, Kelly, and they would be happy to send you links to Zoom calls. And every month he does a Zoom call with his fans, which is the coolest thing in my opinion, because, you know, most people, you get lucky if you can, you know, get a reply from any, you know, people you meet who you look up to. And the fact that he does a monthly Zoom with his meetings just shows that his level of engagement with his fans is off the roof. But I'm super thankful. I'm not gonna thank him 40 more times, because I'm sure this video is already getting way too long as it is. But anybody, please go become a member of SeaMonsterCove.com. It's only $3.99 a month. You get incredible content, a lot of cool merchandise on there. Visit his website, SeaBelton.com, subscribe to his newsletter. And you know what? If you're curious about what a real, proper Megalodon series is, read the Meg. He rewrote the first book to align with the movie, and it is incredible. Purgatory, which is the last in the series, comes out in probably a couple years' time when the movie comes out. And thank you, Steve, for everything that you've done for the shark and or Megalodon community. And we appreciate you being the modern day father of the prehistoric predator. and bringing it to a big generation of children and families, so that everyone can see and love this predator, and basically have a mascot. I know everyone says, "Oh, you know, who do you look up to, like a scientist?" Or, you know, I look up to this man. Steve Alton is my hero, and hopefully he sees and hears this, and yeah. But that's going to conclude this. I've been rambling on for way too long. I hope everybody likes and subscribes. This is going to be hopefully the best place on YouTube to get all Megalodon content. And I will talk to everybody in my next video. And have a great day.